Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Times Up Ummah. Today's first news update is coming from Gaza, where Al Jazeera's building has been hit by an Israeli air raid to stop Al Jazeera from reporting the brutal situation in Gaza and Palestine. Dear viewers, Al Jazeera is the only news outlet which reported consecutively the Israeli aggression against the peaceful Palestinians and how they took down their buildings. It was not immediately clear if there were casualties in such a day's attack. Live Al Jazeera video show that the 11-story Al Jala building, which also houses several residences and other offices, crashing to the ground after being bombed as dust and debris blew into the air. A statement from Al Jazeera condemned the attack, calling on all media and human rights institutions to join forces and denouncing the bombing and to hold the government of Israel accountable. Dear viewers, Al Jazeera's statement said, Al Jazeera condemns in the strongest terms the bombing and destruction of its offices by the Israeli military in Gaza and views this as a clear act to stop journalists from conducting their scared duty to inform the world and report events on the ground. Al Jazeera promises to pursue every available route to hold the Israeli government responsible for its actions. Dear viewers, if any Muslim country would done it, what do you think? What would be the United States' stance? Please tell us in the comments box below. And you may now know that how the Zionists control the whole United States, because the United States even can't condemn the Israeli aggression. And here Israel has said its fighter jets attack a high-rise building which hosted military assets belonging to the military intelligence of the Hamas terror organization. It added the building also hosted offices of civilian media outlets, which the Hamas terror group hires behind and uses as human shields, and provided no evidence. An Al Jazeera's reporter has said, I have been working in this office for more than 10 years and I have never seen anything suspicious. He added, I even asked my colleagues if they have seen anything suspicious, and they all confirmed to me that they have not seen any military aspects or the fighters even coming in and out. Dear viewers, now that's up to you to judge how much United States seriously want the freedom of speech and human rights. Today's second news update is coming from Afghanistan, where the ceasefire in Afghanistan have been ended and fighting between both sides have been started once again in different parts of the region. The Afghan military spokesman has said fighting resumed on Sunday on the outskirts of Lashkargah, the capital of restive southern province of Helmand. He said Taliban fighters attacked security checkpoints on the outskirts of Lashkargah and other districts. But the Taliban has said the Afghan forces started the operation. Don't put the blame on us. So the attacks have been resumed and we hope it will not go that much worse, because Afghans are now tired of continuous war and fighting. Some countries are still looking for a peace settlement to solve the decades-long unrest and bring peace to the Afghanistan, because that's enough for Afghanistan, and now they need to come to a political settlement. As you know, 40 years before when Russia invaded Afghanistan, the jihad was started by the Afghan people and they compelled Russia to escape from Afghanistan, and Russia did it. Between the Russia and the United States invasion, Afghanistan have seen peace for some years under the Taliban government attacked Afghanistan, but as United States attacked Afghanistan once again, gone for an unlimited war, and the whole world, even the United States, has called it its longest war. Today's third news update is coming from Palestine, where the Israeli air raids of the Gaza Strip entered its seventh consecutive day with air raids early on Sunday, killing at least 33 Palestinians, wounding dozens more and flattening at least two residential buildings. A huge fear has now spread in Israel, and as sirens starts, the Israeli people enters the bomb shelters. The latest information which is coming from Palestine is more than 180, including at least 52 children, have been killed in the Gaza Strip in the past week. More than 1,000 others have been wounded. In the occupied West Bank, Israeli forces have killed at least 13 Palestinians. And according to Israel, till now, Israel has reported 10 dead from different rocket attacks from Gaza. The Israeli army has said Israel has faced the highest ever rate of rocket attacks on its territory during from Gaza. Dear viewers, since Monday, armed groups in Gaza have fired 3,000 rockets towards Israel, surpassing the pace during an escalation in 2019 and during the 2006 war with Lebanon. denounce Hezbollah. Ali Hijazi, deputy regional director at Amnesty International Middle East and North Africa, told Al Jazeera that Israel was trying to hide what it was doing in Gaza and to the people of Gaza, adding that Amnesty International was prevented from entering the enclave since 2012. He said, "We have now an international criminal court investigation open on the situation in the Palestinian territories since 2014. We call on the ICC to look into the incident. Even if there is a legitimate military target, it is disproportionate to attack a building in such a manner." Dear viewers, that was the latest news updates from Palestine. If you want to watch top 3 news of the day, please subscribe Times of Ummah.